Welcome to Physical Geography. My name is Professor Corder. Let's get going, shall we? This class is fundamentally about the Earth system. And the Earth system is an interrelated system. What that means is that each part is tied to the other parts. The Earth system has four components to it. They are the atmosphere, the lithosphere, the hydrosphere, and the biosphere. Something you're going to notice as we go on throughout this class is that there are many Latin and Greek rooted words. For example, atmos is the word for air. In Greek, sphere means ball, like the planet itself is a spherical object. Lith is one of the words for rock, so lithosphere is talking about the solid earth. Hydro, well, I think you know what a fire hydrant is. You know that when you exercise, you should hydrate. So hydro has to do with waters. And then bios is the word for life in Greek. We're going to begin by looking at the atmosphere. The atmosphere is the blanket of air surrounding the Earth that consists mainly of a mixture of gases. Think about this for a minute. If it's a cold winter evening, why do you pull a blanket over your body? That's correct, to keep you warm. But the blanket itself, if it's not an electric blanket, is not giving you any heat. What the blanket does is it prevents heat energy from leaving your body and then escaping into the outer atmosphere. And so the blanket blocks that heat energy from leaving, keeping your own body heat surrounding your body and thus insulating you. The atmosphere acts as an insulating body. And in fact, because our planet is about 93 million miles away, we are actually too far away from the sun. That's right. The only thing that's keeping us alive on this planet is the fact that our atmosphere is composed of the specific gases it's composed of. Let's take a look at those gases, shall we? Do you know what the most prevalent gas in the atmosphere is? For a lot of people, they think it's oxygen. It's not oxygen. The most prevalent gas in the atmosphere is nitrogen, which is about 78% of the atmosphere. The chemical symbol for nitrogen is N. Oxygen is the second most prevalent gas in the atmosphere. It accounts for about 21% of the atmosphere. Oxygen is O2. Argon accounts for about 0.9% of the atmosphere. Argon is AR. And if you look at this, we are at 99.9% of the atmosphere. Tonight, when the planet goes around the backside and you are in darkness and you're no longer visible to the sun, at that point, if the next gas is not in our atmosphere, the temperatures would drop by 400 degrees and we would all freeze solid, which tells you something about our atmosphere. That gas is carbon dioxide or CO2, which accounts for about 0.04% of the atmosphere. 0.04% of the entire atmosphere is the thing that's going to keep this planet livable tonight when we're on the dark side. Now, I put 0.0413 on there because the amount of carbon dioxide, as you are probably aware, is rising in the atmosphere. Our Earth system is a tightly wound system. 0.04% is the right amount. We don't want this to be 1%, or that would cause the temperatures to be too high. And we'll speak more about this when we talk about the greenhouse effect and global warming. The rest of the atmosphere, at least for this moment in the class, is going to be classified as other, 0.06%. The second part of the atmosphere is the lithosphere. This is the solid crust of the Earth, including the landforms, rocks, minerals, and soils. In other words, it's dirt. The third part is the hydrosphere, which is all the waters of the Earth, including the oceans, lakes, rivers, glaciers, and clouds, almost all of which you can see in those two pictures. And then finally is the biosphere. This is all of the life of Earth, including the plants, animals, insects, bacteria, you and me. So to give you an idea of how tightly wound this system is, by definition, you as a living person are part of the biosphere. Are you also part of the hydrosphere? Well, I'm not a biologist, but what are we, 80% water? Something like that? And you know that if you dehydrate too much, you die. So we're part of the biosphere, and we are also part of the hydrosphere. Are we part of the lithosphere? Well, if you look at the back of a box of cornflakes, what does it say is in it? Calcium, magnesium, iron. That calcium is the same calcium that makes up your bones. It also makes up stalactites. It's not a different calcium, it's the same one. The iron that we use to build buildings with and make steel out of is the same iron that's in your blood. So we're part of the lithosphere also. What about atmosphere? Are we part of the atmosphere and the atmosphere us? Well, if you do this, then obviously you are taking in atmosphere and exhaling atmosphere. And as you're probably aware, our bodies are trying to get oxygen in to oxygenate our cells. And at the same time, when we exhale, we make a gas called carbon dioxide. So we are also part of the atmosphere, and the atmosphere is part of us. We need all of those parts, and the Earth needs all of those parts as well.